I'm Jonas Olofsson, and I'm a professor of psychology at Stockholm University. My role as a professor here is to do research about the sense of smell, and I also teach students and supervise PhD students. So my research team investigates the sense of smell in humans, and we do this by different types of experimental techniques. So we test how well do people perceive smells and remember them, and how well are people at describing the smells that they perceive. The reason why I started writing this book is that I wanted to share all the incredible discoveries that my colleagues in the sense of smell research community has been doing for the past decades. But then during the process of writing this book, the pandemic hit. So people were starting to contact me, showing their symptoms, telling me about their suffering after having lost their sense of smell through COVID. So that gave me the motivation to actually finish the work. The coronavirus attacks the olfactory epithelium inside the nose, and it disrupts the neural processing of smells. So the smells can't reach the brain. And that became very early on, that became the strongest symptom of the coronavirus disease. So people started losing their sense of smell, but they didn't know why. And many of them never recovered. So that was a great suffering that happened to millions of people. And many of them don't feel like they got the recognition for their suffering that they needed. People were saying that maybe it doesn't matter, the sense of smell doesn't matter whether you have it or not. So their suffering wasn't really cared for. It wasn't really considered by other people. So in my book, I would like to educate people also about how important the sense of smell is and why it matters so much to us. When people are disgusted by body odors, that tells you a lot about their personality, their political beliefs, and their ideology, and how they want society to be organized. So we have found a strong link between olfactory disgust and authoritarian political disposition. And this has been shown in all inhabited continents of the world. So this is not just a US phenomenon, it's a global phenomenon. My own experiences from growing up in the north of Sweden and being a big fan of the fermented herring, the surströmming that we eat locally in the north, that I carried those experiences with me in the book. And I write about surströmming dinner in the start of the book. But most people really hate it. And I think it's a good example of how we perceive smells is very individual, and it's based on what we have learned to associate and our learned emotions and experiences. And the sense of smell is a very associative sense. So people respond differently to the same smell. And that's one of the things that are really amazing and wonderful with the sense of smell. It tells us something about who we are. When it comes to our emotional connection to other people, their personal smells and how we perceive them, that's very important. So if we are attached to someone, their sense of smell will elicit those warm emotions. So people who lose their sense of smell, they sometimes get problems with their emotional lives, their attachment to their partner and their family members, and their sexual lives also suffer. So there's a lot of hidden problems that come with smell loss. And I write about this in several chapters in the book. The human sense of smell is very sensitive, and we actually outperform most other species with the exception of the dog. So we have a very sensitive smell, and the unique strength with the human sense of smell is that we have a lot of brain powers. We have a lot of cognitive resources, a lot of intellectual resources that we can use to analyze smells and to associate the smells with different experiences and emotions. So that is a strength that has to do with the unique human brain. If you have lost your smell due to COVID, you have about 3 times better odds of actually recovering your sense of smell due to smell training if you do it for about 4 months. So it takes time and effort, but it is possible. Everyone has either experienced this smell loss, or they know someone who experienced smell loss during the pandemic. And that can be a really traumatic experience. People become depressed if they don't regain the sense of smell. So I think that there was a realization that this sense really matters. So we need to learn more about it. And I think that's why people are showing interest in my book.